Hare Krishna. We need to forgive ourselves to give ourselves to Krishna. When we commit some mistakes, especially when there are some moral lapses on our part, then we may feel guilty, we may feel regretful, and we may beat ourselves down. Why did I do such a thing? Or even if we commit some practical mistakes and they have some serious consequences, at that time also we may beat ourselves down. Why did I do this? Certainly it's important for us to take responsibility for our mistakes. At the same time, we also need to forgive ourselves. Because if we are not forgiving ourselves, then that just as if somebody is very unforgiving towards us, then that unforgiving attitude creates a tension in our relationship with them. And that tension prevents the two of them to work harmoniously in any way. Similarly, if we are unforgiving towards ourselves, that creates an inner tension within us. And that inner tension weakens us. So if we are beating ourselves up internally, then we cannot offer ourselves wholeheartedly to Krishna. Ultimately, if you want to grow spiritually, it is not just about doing a particular action right. It is about offering our very being to Krishna. And if we consider that we are to offer ourselves to Krishna, then if we are beating ourselves up so much that we are discouraged, we are disheartened, we are practically good for nothing, then what is it that we are offering to Krishna? Is it really worth offering to Him? So forgiving ourselves doesn't mean that we minimize or deny the wrongs that we have done. It simply means that we don't use the past wrong as a stick for beating ourselves perpetually. We accept that those wrongs happened, but Krishna is kind enough to still be with us in our own hearts. And Krishna is kind enough to guide us even now. So now we take whatever opportunity we have to surrender to Him. The Bhagavad Gita in its 18th chapter talks about how all of us are controlled by our nature. We are all bound by our nature, but it says that even according to our nature, we can serve Krishna. It says in 18.60 that Swabhava Jena Kaunteya Nibaddha Svena Karmana Kartum Nechasi and Mohat Karishasya Vishopitad. That we are bound by our nature and we have to act according to our nature. But then the Gita takes our vision higher and it says that above our nature is the Lord of nature. Ishvara Sarva Bhutanam Hriddeshe Arjuna Tishtati Brahmayan Sarva Bhutani Yantra Rudhani Mayaya. That Supreme Lord who is inside our hearts is guiding our wanderings. And then the next verse 18.62 says, Tameva Sharanam Gacha Sarva Bhavena Bharata Tat Prasadat Param Shantim Sthanam Prapsisi Shashvatam. So Krishna says that surrender to that Supreme Lord. And how surrender? Sarva bhavena, wholeheartedly, with our complete being. So with our mistakes, with our weaknesses, with our faults, we surrender our whole being to Krishna. And Krishna says, I will take you to peace. I will take you to the eternal destination. So if we see that our past mistakes are mistakes, which diverted us from Krishna, but our unforgiving attitude now may keep us further disconnected from Krishna. So we forgive ourselves so that we can move forward in the process of bhakti and give ourselves to Krishna. Thank you. Hare Krishna.